Simone and Kipski have been creating crazy sounds together since they were kids in the city of Utrecht.
We used to go skateboarding, and then when we got tired, we just spent hours pressing pause buttons on cassette decks and trying to make samples, sort of.
Welcome to this Hindenburg Journalist and Hindenburg Journalist Pro tutorial. Here, you can get an overview of some of the features and the layout of the program. Hindenburg Journalist is an audio editing program designed for radio journalists and other audio content providers. The focus is on storytelling and not on audio engineering. The radio journalist has here the tools for organizing, editing, and exporting radio segments quickly and at the same time keeping current radio broadcast standards and even the future loudness-based standards. Hindenburg Journalist guides you towards setting correct broadcast levels and creating radio broadcast sound.
That's Simone Ackermans, the Simone of Simone and Kipski.
That kind of evolved into, you know, more technology. Our first four-track recorder, like tapes, and then the first sampler, and we evolved that into kind of instrumental sample-based hip-hop kind of music.
The name of this story, little boy, little girl today, is the evil.
This is what a radio segment could sound like. And all this is done by using some part of Hindenburg Journalist automation. Let's begin with an overview of some of the features in Hindenburg Journalists. Here we have the workspace where we do the audio montaging. The regions represent the sound. All levels are automatically adjusted when imported into Hindenburg Journalist, so they meet radio broadcast requirements. And this is done by using the EBU R128 recommendations for loudness normalization. This means that all sounds will be perceived as being equally loud, despite differences in dynamic range and compression levels.
Simone and Kipski have been creating crazy sounds together since they were kids in the city of Utrecht.
We used to go skateboarding, and then when we got...
You can get more tips about automated levels in another tutorial or from the user guide. At the left, we find the track controls. Here we find the overall controls for each track. Prepare the track for recording, soloing, or muting. You can also find the voice profiler. This automatically applies an equalization for your narration. Either use the generic profile, or if you have the Hindenburg Journalist Pro version, you can create your own unique EQ. See more tips on this in the following tutorial. When you do apply a voice profiler, the effect will show up in the effects bin. The effects bin is where you can add plugins, use internal or third-party plugins. For more tips on effects, please view the user guide. From the effects list, we can also find the loudness meter. Loudness is the upcoming standard for measuring audio levels and are currently being adopted by broadcasters all over the world. The loudness meter is a custom part of Hindenburg Journalist Pro.
Simone and Kipski have been creating crazy sounds together since they were kids in the city of Utrecht.
We used to go skateboarding, and then when we got tired, we just spent hours pressing pause buttons on cassette decks and trying to make samples, sort of.
That's Simone Ackermans, the Simone of Simone and Kipski.
That kind of evolved into, you know, more technology.
In the clipboard, it's possible to organize audio clips before montaging. You can add single audio clips or even grouped clips. Markers are used for simple navigation in the workspace. This is useful for keeping an overview of your story's structure. With the call recorder, it's possible to do a Skype recording. Simply call through Skype and record the interview. And the interview will be stored in the clipboard for later use.
Hello, welcome to Skype call testing service. After the beep, please record a message. Afterwards, your message will be played back to you.
The clock can help you keep track of time if you're working towards a deadline. This is where you can add chapters, images, and links to your radio segment. This can be used for enhanced podcasts, and in the future, we will also see this being used for digital radio formats. This was a very short overview of Hindenburg Journalist and Hindenburg Journalist Pro. In the next tutorial, we'll go in more depth with the different elements. Thank you for watching.